This is a hall sensor installed in the front load washer's motor. I will tell you its types, working, and how to test it in this video. This inverter direct drive motor is installed in front and top load washers. And this hall sensor is installed above the stator, which detects the drum speed. It also tells at what speed the rotor is rotating and where the rotor's or drum's position is when rotating. This is why this hall sensor is very useful. This complete is called a hall sensor, but a couple of sensors are installed on its circuit board, called hall effect sensors. I have removed one sensor from here for testing it. Now, whether a motor is DC or AC, as this is a DC inverter motor, the rotor of this motor has permanent magnets installed inside it. So how does this works? Whenever any motor rotates, the north pole is made on one side of the motor, and the other side is the south pole. Then the motor works. Otherwise, it will not work. They will repel each other when the south pole is placed with the south pole. And when the south pole is placed with the north, they will attract each other. And due to this, the motor work, otherwise, it will not. Now let me make you understand how the effect of the north and south pole takes place on this hall sensor. Before that, let me tell you how many types are of hall sensors. So it has two types. The first is unipolar. Through this type of hall sensor, we can get digital signals. The second type is bipolar. This can be used to get analog or linear signals. Now there is a difference between the two of them. So now let's see what the difference is between them. The first example we will see of a unipolar hall sensor of how the hall sensor works in unipolar. Also, we will see its second example as well. I have attached an LED light and a resistor with the hall sensor. Now I am attaching the battery supply, the positive with the resistor, and the negative in the center of the hall sensor. Now I need a magnet. I have two kinds of magnets with me right now. This is a ring magnet, and I don't know about its polarity. This is the bar magnet with the north and south poles written on it. Now I will explain and test how the unipolar hall sensors work and how they switch. Now I will bring the north side of the magnet close to the sensor, this is the backside, and this is the front side of the hall sensor. When I brought the north pole on the backside of the hall sensor, the LED light glowed. So whenever you install a hall sensor, always install it in its correct position. If the position is incorrect, the machine will work for some time and then show the hall sensor error. When I brought the south pole near the hall sensor on the backside, the light was not glowing. This is how digital signals are obtained from the unipolar hall sensor. Because it gets on and off, means, it acts as 0 and 1 signals. This is how it makes digital signals. When I brought the magnet closer to the side of the hall sensor, it is not working. The same is on the other corner of the hall sensor. Now let me show you it has one another effect. As I have brought the north of the magnet closer to the front side of the hall sensor, it is not working. But it worked when I brought the south closer to the front side of the hall sensor. This means the effect of the magnet is different on the front and back sides of the hall sensors. Now if I test it with the ring magnet, I don't know what is north and the south pole in the ring magnet. As I brought the magnet near the back side of the hall sensor, it didn't work. It means this is the south pole of the ring magnet. Now, when I place the south on the front side of the hall sensor, it is working. This flat side is the north pole of the ring magnet. This is the testing circuit of the hall sensor. You can pause the video and take a screenshot of it. Now with another example, we will understand the effect of the unipolar hall sensor that how they work. You can see that I have installed two sensors on the breadboard. Also, I have installed two LEDs. The same resistor of 10 kilo ohms is installed, and I have installed both sensors facing in different directions. To check how they function and to check whether the hall sensor is faulty or not. Now I will install the wires of the battery. First, I am bringing the north pole near the hall sensors. The green light has glowed. As both the sensors are attached in reverse. Now I have brought the south pole near the sensors, so the blue light has started to glow. And the same effect will be seen when I place the magnet on the other side of the hall sensor. And this is the two hall sensor testing circuit. Next, I will check the bipolar field effect hall sensor or switch. This switch is mostly used to get linear or analog signals. And then, further, in the PCB, using an operational amplifier, the analog signals are converted to digital signals. The pin configuration of the unipolar Hall sensor and this bipolar Hall sensor are the same. But if you have a different Hall sensor, check its datasheet, and check it according to it. Now I will pass electricity through this bipolar Hall sensor. Let's see, when I supply electricity, what will be the difference from the unipolar? That is why I am supplying electricity slowly. I have installed the positive terminal of the battery. You will understand the difference if you have watched the video carefully. And do comment on what difference you saw in the bipolar Hall sensor. Now I have supplied electricity with the negative pin of the Hall sensor. As you can see the difference, I think you would have understood the difference. Who understood do comment, and who didn't watch the video further? As when I supplied electricity to the circuit. The bipolar Hall sensor has been directly turned on and will always turn on when electricity passes. Whether we turn it off or on with a magnet, it will stay in the same position. Let me show you how. Making it turn on and off, the north and south poles also play an important role here. When I bring the north pole closer to the Hall sensor, it does not affect it. Now as I brought the south pole near the Hall sensor, the light turned off from a distance, as the magnet is not even closer to the sensor. Which means it turns off at the south pole. And when I brought the north pole near the Hall sensor, it turned on the Hall sensor, and when I removed it, the light kept glowing. And it will turn off when the south pole comes near the bipolar Hall sensor. And this is a big difference from the unipolar Hall sensor. You can also check two bipolar Hall sensors. The circuit is the same as I made for the unipolar. This bipolar Hall sensor gives analog signals because of the behavior. It remains on or off unless and until triggered with the magnet. And then, further, in the PCB, it is converted to digital output. Then it tells the microcontroller the motor's position and at what speed it works. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. It is free. Thank you.